The wife of slain Governor Roel Degamo is convinced her husband's death was politically motivated. This, as she notes, the attack came just 2 weeks after the Supreme Court decision upholding Governor Degamo's win over rival Pride Henry Teves in 2022.
It was the frustration of the election that led them to do that. If you have seen their guns and ammunition, baka talo pang military.
Pamplona Mayor Janice Degamo also asserts her husband's death could have been prevented if only authorities listened to their call to address the rising lawlessness in the province.
Pwede niyo pong tignan doon sa Senate, bago pa mangyari ang lahat ng ito, long before the 2022 election, may final ang mga victims of murder, land grabbing, etc. Doon sa Senate, ako po yung sumulat sa Senado on their behalf. May resolution yun, hindi na take up. Kung napansin lang sana talaga kaagad, it could have prevented this thing.
Philippine Senator Bato de la Rosa echoes Mayor Degamo's sentiments. He says the culture of violence in the province has been on the rise since last year. De la Rosa now suggests a more proactive approach to mitigate the problem.
We encourage the Commission on Human Rights to field more human rights investigators doon sa area ng Negros Oriental. Yung mga investigator nila sa region, at saka yung sa Cebu, kung walang ginagawa, ipapapapuntahin na nila doon sa Negros Oriental para magtulong-tulong sila doon sa pag-imbestiga. Very harsh policy man, pero wala nang ibang paraan kundi bigyan natin sila ng one-strike policy. Lahat ng mga Cebu police dyan, lahat ng mga provincial directors, lahat ng regional directors, kapag may mga political killings dyan sa area ninyo, isang pangyayari lang, tanggal kayo, papalitan ko kayo.
The Armed Forces of the Philippines has said it will be sending 6 battalions to help quell lawlessness in Negros Oriental. Authorities on Friday also announced the creation of a task force and deployment of troops to help restore normalcy in the island. The Philippine Justice Secretary reiterates no one will be spared in the probe into the slay of Governor Degamo. That was Secretary Jesus Remulla's answer when asked if former Congressman Pride Henry Teves, who was unseated by Degamo this year, is covered by the investigation. One of the suspects had linked a so-called Kong Teves to the crime.
Siyempre, pag sinabi natin that we will not spare anybody, lahat yan under investigation. We are not exempting anybody from investigation as long as they may have a possible relationship or motive to be a part of the trouble.
Several firearms and explosives were recovered by authorities Friday from the properties of Congressman Arnolfo Teves. But what exactly were the weapons recovered from Teves's properties? Tomas Valmonte, the chief legal office of the Philippine National Police Criminal Investigation and Detection Group, told ABS-CBN they seized 3 grenades, 10 short firearms, 6 M4 rifles, and 22 assorted magazines.
Wala pong lisensya. At kahit po may lisensya yon, as early as January, ni-revoke na po ang kanyang LTOP at mga ibang licenses and permits with regard to firearms.
The camp of the embattled lawmaker set to take legal action following a raid on his properties in Negros Oriental. Teves's lawyer, Ferdinand Topacio, asserts they already surrendered his guns to authorities.
Why would we surrender firearms bago magtitira pa kami ng mas marami pa kesa sa sinurrender namin? Definitely, we will be taking all legal steps para mapangalagaan po ang karapatan ni Arnie Teves. We are confident, and the reason for our confidence is the simple fact that he did not do it.
Justice Secretary Remulla says Teves is on his way home from a personal trip to the U.S. Attorney Topacio said Teves went there for medical treatment.